Azure Integration Services provides an enterprise-ready, event-based serverless compute experience that drives efficiency and consistency when connecting applications across the cloud and on-premises. Matt Farmer is here to show us how we're bringing together API management, event grids, logic apps, and service bus in a more consistent way. Today on Azure Friday. Today on Azure Friday, we're talking about Azure Integration Services. And with me, I've got Matt Farmer, who is a program manager for Integration Services. Matt, what are you going to show us today that's going to make life a lot easier for the developer?
So I'm going to talk about what we're planning to do and what we're doing with Azure Integration Services. I want to start by talking about the term IPaaS, because it's kind of how we talk about this, what we're planning to do. It's a lot of people within the kind of enterprise application space are talking about this term IPaaS, which is Integration Platform as a Service. And we have customers coming to us asking us, well, what have you got for IPaaS? How are you putting this together? So Azure Integration Services is based on some key components that we see customers needing to deploy when they want a solid platform for enterprise integration.
Okay.
So this is less, I just want to build one application. This is more, I have many applications that I want to build that connect me to my partners, to things like apps, and to within the business itself. How do I put those things together into a solid, reusable platform that gives me benefits from not having to design an application every time?
Okay. So you've got today we've got a number of components that are available in Azure.
Absolutely. So we see some key components as being part of this. So we have APIs, workflows and orchestration, really, enterprise messaging, and events. So being able to build applications with event-driven architecture. So we have services that embody each of those. So API management for publishing and securing APIs. Logic apps allows you to create workflows and orchestration. Azure Service Bus as an enterprise messaging queue for messages. And Azure Event Grid, which is our new platform for building event-driven applications. So those four things come together as Azure Integration Services. So we see them as being, by deploying those four pieces, customers can build a reliable, reusable platform on Azure that allows them to build all the integrations they want to build as part of their enterprise architecture.
Okay.
And there's some key things that are part of that. So for example, being API driven. So a lot of customers are talking about the API economy and how they can enable parts of their business, parts of their applications into APIs that allow them to connect to people. The Azure Integration Services embodies that, allows people to use APIs all the way through their integration. Serverless, so Logic Apps, for example, is a serverless platform, so they don't have to deploy a huge infrastructure to get started. They can do it based on whatever the amount of stuff they're using.
Okay, so we've had all of these four services up to now.
Yes.
How does Azure Integration Services make them better?
Well, I think that the first thing to say is that a lot of customers don't want to take on a lot of risk. So we have these four things in Azure. Yes, somebody could go and deploy them today, but the question they quite often ask us is, well, how many other customers have done this? How many other have you put your name to any ways of doing this, Microsoft, so that I don't have to take all the risk when I do this myself? So the first part of doing this is making sure that we provide guidance, that we provide kind of the commitment that we're going to think about these services together, going to give you guidance on how to deploy and run them, so that you don't have to take on that risk yourself.
Oh, that's good.
The second thing is thinking about ways we can make these services work together more seamlessly. So making sure that we file off any rough edges in integrating them together, and also make sure that we're thinking through those ways in which customers are using them together to make sure those scenarios work.
Okay.
Again, it provides a reassurance. So if I'm either a developer thinking about how I build my application or a CIO of a company, I can go to Microsoft and say, well, what have you got and is it tried and trusted and, you know, is the thing I want to build going to work?
Right. So what are you going to show us? Can you walk us through an example of how
we can use
integration services?
So if I flipped it, I've got a slide here. I'm just going to jump ahead. So Just to make absolutely clear, before we do that, just making it clear that you don't have to use these things on their own.
Right.
People say, quite often say, well, I've got those four things. What if I want to use functions to write some custom code? Well, of course, all the other Azure services come with this and absolutely will connect to Azure Integration Services through logic apps or service bus or API management. And we've also got this whole connector library that we have in logic apps that connect to all sorts of services that aren't even in Azure that are SaaS services or enterprise systems. But let's move on to a quick demo that walks us through how it works. So I'm just going to use a slide to explain this, just to give you an example. If you imagine a system that processes orders that a customer may have to deploy. So generally, if you're a big enterprise, there's all sorts of systems you'll connect to process an order. There's probably three or four of them. Now, you can imagine a logic app being the thing that does that. But it probably is something that maybe takes a little while, isn't something that you want to delay any customer processes based upon, and one that you want to run all day and all night based on when those systems run efficiently. So we could trigger that logic app with Event Grid. Event Grid can tell the logic app when to run, when there's stuff to do, and not have that logic app running when there's no stuff to do, so it saves you money. If we imagine Service Bus being the place where we store all these messages, so we can place a message on this queue, have it doing things like deduplication, have reliable disaster recovery in that message queue, so that you know that the place where all the things that have come in is in that queue. Another logic app that then places the message on there. So we've got two logic apps. Why are we separating them up? Well, because we have one business action that is make this order happen, and we have another business action that is take this order in and create an order ID for it. So that's what that logic app would do. And then fronting all that, I talked about this being API driven. The logic app, the first logic app that we have there is a request response HTTP API. So we can front that in API management and provide it out to either our apps or to partners to be able to create an order.
Okay.
So that was a lot of words. Let's have a look what that actually is. I will move across to my demo. So Fabricam, we're all familiar with them, the great things that they do. We've got those components here in Azure. So we have our connectors. So Logic Apps has this concept of connectors, being able to connect out to things so you don't have to write that code yourself. And then we have our Logic App. So the first one was Receive Orders. So let's just have a quick look at that. So Receive Orders takes in an order object. Oops, let's go up to the top. From Event Grid. So Event Grid says, I've got an order to process. We go into Service Bus and we get those messages. And then we loop around them because it's a collection that comes back and do all the things we need to do to actually make that order received and processed and shipped. I mean, I'm doing silly things like posting to Teams and sending an email here, but you can imagine connecting to SAP or Dynamics or any other systems you have, custom systems.
It could be
systems.
In Azure, it could be elsewhere, on-prem,
exactly. It could be in
clouds.
Your data center.
Right.
Could be in your data center or in another cloud if you really want. But that logic app is concerned with that process. So from a documenting what your business does point of view, that logic app is documenting that receive order process. We have Service Bus topic actually set up rather than a queue, because actually you may have business parts of the system that need to go and get messages from a queue, and they also want to know about those orders. So the topic allows us to do that. The other logic app we have is the Process Orders logic app, which is popping messages onto that Service Bus queue. So effectively, this logic app is just concerned with someone wants an order, put it into the system and forget.
Right.
So then you return to the customer as quickly as possible an order ID and say, you know, we've got your order, we'll worry about it. So this one is doing, it's actually an HTTP request response. So this is an API operation. It's creating a record in Dynamics. We do some JSON handling to compose it into our order object. And then we send the message to Service Bus and respond saying, we got you. And then finally, API management. If we go in here, we can see that this, I actually created this API by importing it with the logic app button here. So again, just emphasizing that we make it as easy as possible to build out these solutions without having to write a lot of code. You can add code if you want to, but you don't have to. And then we have our V1 orders here, which is the process order API configured, ready to go. Now, the people at the back, the people consuming this API have no idea that you're using Logic Apps and Service Bus and whatever else. It's just an API that you've provisioned out to your users, your apps, whatever. And we can see it in the developer portal. So if your developers or partners wanted to come in and develop an API based upon it, they could see things like the sample that they need to pass into the API. They can see the responses they're going to get back, and they can even test it.
Great, great. So with integration services, you've made a commitment that all of these services are going to work together in an easy, flawless
way.
Absolutely.
So you can build
that
iPaaS
application. Smooth out the rough edges.
Absolutely.
Okay. And what's to come with integration services?
So the first thing we want to do is make sure we've got as much guidance and documentation out there for people to use. We're looking at other features that we can add, so that removing rough edges so that we can, for example, make it really easy to deploy from one service to another with a click of a button or through automation templates.
Right. For a lot of those common scenarios.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And provide guidance for those. So if we can provide ARM templates to say, you know, build me what I just showed here with one ARM template and then configure from there, you can do that. So that's what's on the short-term roadmap. Okay. And then later we've got some ideas for features that we haven't quite tied down yet, but there's a bunch of features we'd like to add to this that we'll be looking to produce as well.
Well, that's great. Well, thank you so much for showing up today and walking through the Azure Integration Services. I think it's going to be a great help to simplify the life when, you know, we're building out these common applications.
Great. Thank you.
Okay. So today we've been learning all about Azure Integration Services on Azure Friday.